Hey dolls! So today I'm actually going to be doing an updated rat cage tour. It has been quite a while since my last one, and just a few things have changed here and there. I kept most of the same layout, but I wanted to show you a few things that I've added or tweaked around. So first and foremost, before I get into this video, you can see a new face right here. I recently lost Star Lily. She passed away. She just got old and she just couldn't handle it anymore, so she did pass away. And you guys know that rats are very, very, very social creatures. They need to be kept in numbers of at minimum of two. I really didn't want Trixie to start feeling lonely. This is Trixie. You guys saw her, you met her in my last cage tour video. I got her as a cage mate for Star because Luna had passed away. And this time, instead of getting a baby or one that was younger, I actually requested and got one that was a little bit over a year. So she is more of Trixie's age. So, and as you can see, she is a Siamese. Anyway, this is Hope. And she is a sweetie. So we have Hope up here. She is the Siamese with the little brown nose. And then we have Trixie down here, who is the like fawn sable colored one. And as you can see, Trixie has black eyes and Hope has red eyes. Hi. Hi, baby girl. These are actually two separate cages stacked on top of each other. My fiance helped me and we kind of DIY'd this. And we took these two cages, cut the top off one of them, stacked them on top of each other, and then zip tied them together. You can see, I'll link my original cage tour down below so you can kind of see what I'm talking about. But I will also link the two cages that I got. If you are going to get rats, please, 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 number one, do your research. And number two, do not get just one of these cages for your rats. They need a minimum of two of them. I just wanted to expand my rat space or my rat cage. And so I built upward instead of outward. So I built up vertically instead of horizontally. If you plan on getting girls, they need a lot of vertical space because they are more adventurous and they really love to climb and just adventure everywhere. But if you get boys, they tend to be a little bit more lazy, so they will probably benefit more from horizontal space rather than vertical. But my girls, they love to climb, so we got them this cage. Okay, so I'm just gonna start at the top level and work down. You guys saw this little space pod here before. I got this off of the Chewy website, I believe. Then I have this little fleece, little microfiber blanket. I get these at Dollar Tree. They're actually meant for washing your car, but they love them as little cozy blankets. So there is that. And then this hammock right here is actually from Cozy Beds on Instagram. I will link them in the description box, but they make these awesome hammocks. They are made so beautifully. They make these, and 15% of all of their profits go to Melody Rats Rescue on Instagram, and I will link them as well. I've actually personally donated, I think, either $20 or $50 to Melody Rats Rescue, and they basically work off donations to provide the best life for their little rescues until they can get adopted. So definitely check them out if you are a small pet owner. They have tons of different colorways and patterns. This one just has cute little popsicles all over it. And again, they are pretty well made, and my girls absolutely love them. So this is a little basket I actually got at Walmart for like 98 cents during Valentine's Day, and I just put some fleece in it. And I also took the handles off so that they wouldn't get stuck in the handles or anything like that, or chew them up or anything. So I actually have them zip tied to the cage. Please, please, please make sure if you are going to use zip ties with your ratties, make sure that you cut off the long tails and also put the jagged edges on the outside of the cage where the rats cannot get them. I personally have never had any issues. You can see up here, I've never had any issues with my rats chewing up the zip ties, so I just keep doing it. The little food bowl is back there. I will leave the link to the food that I feed them. I make my own little recipe, and I will leave that link in the description box as well. Over here, I do a lot of DIY little toys because toys can be crazy expensive. So I just took some toilet paper rolls and I cut a slit in the side of them, stuffed some little paper in there, and I just put those on the sides of the cage. This is a super cheap DIY. You're pretty much just going to throw these toilet paper rolls away or recycle them anyway. So you might as well just give them to your little ratties to chew up and play with. This water bottle, I think I either got from PetSmart or the Chewy website. This bowl right here, I think came from PetSmart. This bowl came from Walmart. I have some strawberries and some celery in there for them. Usually these two bowls are separate. This one's for their food. This one's for their vegetables and fruits. But they decided to put their fruits in that bowl for whatever reason. Then right here we have an old grungy lava ledge. You guys saw these from my last cage tour video, but I get these at PetSmart or on the Chewy website. They're cheaper on the Chewy website, so I tend to go through them. But this one is getting really old and quite honestly kind of disgusting. I am ordering a few more new ones of these so I can completely just junk these ones and then get brand new ones for them. But these are great because every time they stand on it, it helps file their claws down, and then they can chew on them as well. And this is great to put at the base of your water bottle because then they have to stand on it every time they get a drink. So if they don't typically stand on these or use these throughout the rest of the cage, you can put it where it is mandatory for them to use them, so it makes sure and keeps their claws filed down because they have to stand up there every time they want to get a drink of water. Okay, so closing this door, now we are going to move on to the next level. Right here I have a hammock that I got off of a seller on eBay. Unfortunately, she doesn't make or sell hammocks anymore, but this is just a little honeycomb hammock. I have a piece of fleece in here as a blanket. You can see they like to chew up the fleece quite a bit. If you're going to use fabric in your rat cages, please, please, please use fleece because it doesn't have any harsh threading in it or anything, and it is the safest to use for them. Also, I did want to mention that with this cage, it came with these little levels and that you can use as ramps and stuff. It did come with smaller ramps too, but I just don't use them. But as you can see, there is wiring on the bottom right there. Never, ever, 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 ever expose your babies to the wire mesh. Always, always cover it, whether you cover it with fleece or what I like to do is use tube socks. I just cut the toes off of tube socks and then I just put them on the ramps or the little levels as if they are like leg warmers or something. It protects their little feet from developing sores on them. So please, please, please make sure and always cover your mesh. Okay, now back on down here. Like I said, this hammock was from someone on eBay. Back here, I have a little tray basket thing that I got from Dollar Tree. If you're getting baskets like this from Dollar Tree, please also make sure that the holes in the sides and the bottoms and things are not big enough or small enough so that your rat's feet can get stuck in them. That should be kind of obvious, but just wanted to put that disclaimer in there. And then I just have some little fleece in here, and I also attached this with zip ties, as you can see. Right here, I just finished making this awesome little toy contraption. If you guys want to see a DIY for rat toys, I can definitely do that. But basically, it's just made out of some fleece to hold it all together, some toilet paper rolls, some Dixie cups, and paper. And that's really all it is. It's very, very easy and super affordable. Plus, it keeps them busy for hours. They love to take this paper out and nest with it. And I also have little treats hidden in each one of these cups so that they can kind of rip everything apart and get their treats out. Females, because they are so active and hyper, they need stimulation often. So giving them things like this that they can rummage through and chew up is amazing and 100% a must. So the next level right here, in my last cage tutorial, I did not have a litter pan right here. I could not figure out how to put a litter pan in the cage, and I figured it out because these doors are so small that I couldn't put a full-size litter pan in here like the one that I have on the bottom of the cage, which you guys will see in a second. So I went to the store and I found this clear, I don't want to say it's acrylic, but actually it might be. It's just this little container, and what I did is I drilled one little hole in the side right here and attached it with a zip tie so that they can't like knock this over or fling the litter everywhere. So I have that set up on one of these levels, and then I have a sideways level going on in the back right there. And they can kind of fit in that corner or hide in that corner and then just walk down here and then hop down to the next level. So I did end up getting a new litter tray for them right there. So I do have two in the cage now. And as you can see, I have a water bottle up top, a food dish up top, and I also have a water bottle down bottom and a food bowl down underneath on the bottom, which you guys will see in a second. So moving on, we can close up this door and then we will open this door. So up there, you guys saw that this sideways level goes right here. Then I made this little no-sew corner hammock that I just have hung up right here so that they can bounce on it or jump from level to level and things like that, or they could even sleep on here if they wanted to. Then underneath of it, I have a huge tissue box, an empty one, other than paper. I put paper in there for them, but it is just an old tissue box, and I removed the plastic. Please remove the plastic because that can hurt your little ratties. And again, I have it attached back here with a zip tie, so again that they can't just like throw it around the whole cage, but they can go in here, rummage through this paper, they can hide in here, they can sleep in here, they can eat, whatever they want to do. I have a little bowl stuck back here. This is what I use sometimes if I want to change up the pace and give them their fruits and veggies in a different location, or just like individual little treats. I have that bowl there just in case for that. I have another little basket that I got from Dollar Tree, and this one I have secured down with a washer and a bolt, and then I have some shower rings up here to kind of hold the handle in place. And then I have this little bird dish right here. This is actually a bird food dish, but I have this up here just because I like to put papers or treats hidden in it sometimes, and they can just jump up here, grab them out, throw everything everywhere, and make a huge mess is what they love doing. You guys saw these in last cage tours. These are just little plastic Hello Kitties, oops, from like Happy Meals and stuff. They're just like hard plastic, so they can't chew them up. They just like to grab them and kind of bat them around and stuff. They don't really play with them per se, but it's a cute little accent to the cage, I suppose. And then we move on to the bottom. So the bottom of the cage hasn't changed much since my last video, but as you can see, here is the water bottle right here. Here is the food bowl right here. I have this little wooden bridge hut thing. They don't lay under this because it's kind of too small for them, but I use it so that they can climb up on top of it and jump from level to level. Here's one of those lava ledges that is fairly new, so you can see what they look like without being all gross and chewed up. But I have this so they can just basically jump from level to level, as well as to promote chewing. So if they want to chew, they can chew on something like this, as well as the little rat chew toy back there. And then I have the litter pan right here. I got this off of eBay quite a while back. It does have a grate that goes on the top of it, but I took that out because the only one that really made a mess with the litter when I did that was Star. She would kind of like dig in it and like throw it out. So now that she has passed away, I've taken that out and there are no messes with it like there used to be. So, and that's good because the grate was kind of hard on their feet as well whenever they would go down and go potty. Then I have a rock right there, and that is called a pee rock. That is to promote peeing in the litter pan. This doesn't really work per se, but I like to believe it does sometimes. Basically, rats like to pee on rocks, you know. So I got a rock from outside and I cleaned it up really good so that it didn't have any germs or like outside bacteria and stuff on it. I soaked it in scalding hot water for quite a while. But yeah, that is the pee rock, and they pee on that rock. I mean, I don't really know what else to tell you. I do have another one of these little lava ledges right by this water bottle, and then again the food bowl. And down here, these I get off of Chewy, and basically what these are like little kind of, I don't want to say concrete, but they're like little tiles that you can put in chinchilla cages because chinchillas are prone to overheating very easily. And I got these off of the Chewy website, so it's just chewy.com. And I got two of them and I put them side by side. So not only does it help anchor down the fleece that is on the bottom of the cage, as you can see lining it, but this also helps if they are too hot during the summertime. They can come down here, and since this is in the bottom of the cage and heat rises, it stays really, really cool down here. So these are great for them in the summertime if they want to kind of get away from the heat and just kind of sprawl out and lay on these on the bottom of the cage. So they serve a multi-purpose, which I am definitely all about. But yes, I think that is the entire cage tour. I think I basically covered everything. Like I said before, these are two individual cages stacked up on top of each other that I kind of DIY'd. So you can't buy this exact cage in store, but you can buy the two individual cages and kind of DIY it yourself. I just advise, like I said before, definitely cover your little platforms because you don't want your rat's feet getting tore up because of the mesh. And definitely check out Cozy Beds on Instagram. I will link them down below, as I mentioned. And I will also link their food recipe that I use. I also give them fruits and veggies on the daily, if not daily, every other day. And yeah, they just have a very good, substantial diet. And with that being said, I'm going to go ahead and let you guys go. So I hope you all enjoyed this video, and thank you guys for meeting Hope, and let's hope that she loves her new home and that she has a good time with us, because she is just the sweetest girl ever and we love her so much, huh, Trixie? Anyway, yeah, with that being said, I'm gonna go ahead and let you guys go. I hope you all enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a big thumbs up. And if you want to see some rat toy DIYs or cage accessory hauls and things like that, please, please, please let me know in the comments down below. And with that being said, I will talk to you all next time. So until then, so long, stay strong, stay true, and be you. All right. Bye!